And then I'm a third-year student at the University for Development Studies, UDS, Wa Campus, studying Social Science, Political and Historical Studies. I'd like to express my profound gratitude to Dr. Mohamed Buhiji and the entire organization for giving my colleagues and I, Mohamed Hanafi and Christian Kwesi Majid, the opportunity to be part of this great conference. For the purpose of this conference, dubbed Creating Legacy in Times of Crisis, I'll be sharing with you some activities that the International Institute of Inspiration Economy has been embarking on in a country, and then some of the projects that we are currently running that is helping to solve some of the society's socio-economic problems. When Dr. Mohamed Buhiji visited us in Ghana on 27 September 2019, I knew it was going to be a great opportunity for the youth to be empowered and cause a major positive transformation with time that is going to help reduce the level of the impact of the socio-economic problems that we have in the country, which includes high levels of poverty rates, high levels of unemployment, lack of job opportunities, rampant rural urban migration, and so on. Over here in Ghana, my colleagues and I, Mohamed Hanafi and Christian Kwesi Majid, somewhere last year in November, we were able to launch a student competition project where we are engaging the student of TI Ahmadiyya Senior High School in solving some of the society's socioeconomic problems that they can identify in some communities that they are going to choose. So with this project, the students themselves are going to form their own groups and then come up with a problem that they are going to identify in a community and then come up with ways and means to solve some of this problem. With this project, we are hoping that students will be equipped with the skills in solving and identifying some of the problems that they themselves are faced with in the community. So with this, they won't have to wait for anybody to come from outside to come in and teach them how to solve some of their problems. I believe that this is a way forward that is going to really help young kids, the youth and then students to solve some of the problems that they should be able to solve. Going forward, we have been able to identify certain local enterprises that is into the production of shea butter. And then what we are trying to do with this enterprise called ZLB is that we want to go into partnership with them where, with the support from the organization, they are going to be able to expand their level of production, and then they are also going to be able to absorb a lot of women and then youth in this business, and then teach them as well as train them into how to convert shea nuts from shea butter. And then we're also looking at working with similar organizations that is into a similar thing. And then as an organization, what we're also trying to do is to establish a small company that is for now going to be operating mainly on cashew nut and then moringa oil. We have realized that there are a lot of economic trees in the country, and then there are a lot of products that is being developed in the country that is being exported. What we want to do is that we want to put a stop to that by starting a company that is going to be training the youth in some of these activities, and then at the end of the day, what they will do is that they will develop the product and then finally export it. So in the long run, that is what we are looking at. And then also, we've been able to identify an organization called the Academic Achievers. What they do is that they go to rural communities and then engage the youth in the community and children who do not have access to education. They engage them into teaching, where they mostly work with teachers who normally volunteer their services to them, and then they move to these communities and then organize them and then teach them some basic English, basic maths, and then basic principles in life. Yeah, so we are going to be working with such organizations, and then we are going to be expanding our ranks with what we have been learning from the organization and what personally I have been learning from Doc. I've realized that we have within our capacity to do more for the country and then for Africa at large, because we are blessed with lots of resources that is currently underutilized. So with the existence of IIIE in Ghana, we are hoping that we are going to be able to do a lot for the country, such as developing products and then exporting them. And then we are going to be embarking on workshops where we will be engaging the youth in the regions or in the areas that we are going to go to, into how to help them identify some of the problems and then ways and means to solve these problems. And then We're also hoping to equip them and then let them know that there are many of such problems that they do not have to wait for anybody to come from outside to help them solve, but they have within their capacity to solve it. So that is what we have been trying to do so far as an organization. And then so far, we are doing very well with the support from the doctor and then with the support from the organization as well. Thank you. In conclusion, this is what we in Ghana have been able to do so far, and then we are still doing more. When doctor visited Ghana on 27th September 2019, it really opened our eyes into seeing the many opportunities that we have in the country. So we believe that there's more to be done, there's more people to work with, and then we are not done yet. We are still getting there. We are starting small, but we'll be big, just as Doc always say. And then alone we are weak, together we are strong. Thank you very much for this opportunity to be part of you guys. It's really been a privilege, and then you'll be hearing from us more. Thank you. It's all about inspiration economy, and then here we are at where Chietang.
Chietanga.
So we are on the black water, and yes, then we are from Burkina.
Going back to Ghana, you know. And you know, we are made for the international stage, so we're just coming from Burkina back to
Hello Ghana.
Hello Ghana, are you there?